Hello, Jefferson Middle School students. I'm going to start with the region scales that are required. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at the bottom of the page with the chromatic scale because it goes through all of the possible notes. You start the scale at low F and you go up to high F, two ledger lines above the staff. And again, going up, you're hitting every note possible. Going up, you're going to see a lot of notes that you're used to seeing as flat, written as flat notes, written as sharp notes instead. When you come down, you'll see more familiar notes. You'll see B's as B flats instead of when you're going up, it's going to be called an A sharp. When you're going up the chromatic scale. But it's the same notes both ways. You're just going up. And so they use sharps in the chromatic scale when you're going up. So let's get started. The first note is way down there. So I played that slowly. At this point, that may even be a little bit fast for some of you, but that way you could hear each note and you know, possibly be able to play along with that. Okay, so going up to the next scale, we have the concert A-flat scale. Concert A-flat scale has four flats, B-flat, E-flat, A-flat, and D-flat. The tricky one is the D-flat in fifth position. That's the one that catches most people. Most of the other notes, the B-flat, the E-flat, and the A-flat, you're pretty well used to playing, so they shouldn't be as much of a problem. So here's the A-flat concert scale. Again, I'm going to play it on the slow side so that you'll have something to play along with, not too fast. Now we go to the E-flat concert scale, three flats. The notes are easy, the slide patterns are easy. Probably the issue some of you will have is to get the higher notes, the up to the E-flat. So you just kind of have to work on that, keep working on that. Over time, you'll get the upper notes. E-flat, three flats. Now to the B flat. Very common scale. You should already know this. Two flats, B flat scale. You'll notice on that scale, I didn't use my trigger on purpose. I'll play it again using the trigger. The trigger will be for the C, the second note of the scale. That's how I usually play it. And if you do have a trigger, you should play it that way. You should use your trigger on that scale. Okay, then we come to the F scale. It's the only major scale, not the chromatic is not a major scale. It's kind of in a different class. All the rest of these are what we call major scales. The concert F scale is the only one that you play two octaves. of all of the other scales except for the chromatic. So we're, again, we start down low on the low F, but we're going to go two octaves this time. I use the trigger because I have the trigger on the C in that when it came up in the scale. The next scale is the C scale. Oh, by the way, the F concert F scale only has one flat, the B flat. So make sure that you play E naturals in second position and A naturals too. But E naturals is the one that will catch people a lot of times. Okay, so now we go to the C scale. C scale has no sharps, no flats. You're not used to sharps anyway, so that's not a big deal. But no flats is not what you're used to. So the big note here, apart from the E natural, playing the E natural in second position, which you had to play for the F scale, but the big note that's different here is the B. It's not B flat in first position. The high B up there on top of the staff is played in fourth position, and the C is in third position. So here's the C scale. I'm not going to use the trigger on this one, although usually when I play it, I do. And if you have a trigger, you can. We go to the G scale, which is the first scale that we come to that has a sharp, and the first sharp would always be F sharp. So here is the G scale. That means you're going to be playing the B natural in this scale as well, but in this scale you're playing a little bit lower, so you're playing the low B natural, which is seventh position for trombones that don't have a trigger. If you have a trigger, that note is played in second position with the trigger, and then you can play the C in first position with the trigger. I'll go ahead and play it both ways. So this is the concert G scale, first without the trigger. Trigger. So you see, that's a lot easier, not having to go from G, A, second position, all the way out to seventh position. That's about as far as you're going to have to ever go. Second to seventh position. Of course, first to seventh would be longer, but you don't have that in any of these scales. Okay, now the D scale has both F sharp and C sharp in it. No flats. So, and here again, that B is going to be the upper B, so it's going to be the fourth position B on top of the staff. Your first note D, second note E natural, then to F sharp, G, A, B natural, B natural, C sharp. C sharp is second position, which is the same thing as D flat, you know, if you're playing, you know, in a flat key, but C sharp, and then up to first position for D, and then in reverse. So here's the D scale.